Welcome back, student. As we discussed about databases analysis and database retrieval tools, so this is the one of the important aspect or one of the important part of the bioinformatics. Suppose if you want to retrieve the data, if you want to regain the data information of a particular gene, particular amino acid, or a particular protein coding gene, so these all informations are available in the form of the entrenched taxonomy browser, locus link, etc. So similarly, the bioinformatics tools are providing the entire information or description or aspect or aspects of the particular kind of the gene, protein sequence, even regulatory sequence of a protein. So today we will talk about the analysis using bioinformatics tools. What are the bioinformatics tools by which we can analyze or we can obtain or we can infer different kind of information? So today we will talk about the analysis using bioinformatics tool. So many kind of analysis, and what many kind of analysis is there? For example, first one is that we start from the processing raw information. This is the first one. So processing raw information, what is this and how these bioinformatics tools are applicable to find out that information? As we know that Central Dogma Molecular Biology is speaking about that concept, DNA, again that gene, it gives RNA, that we call a messenger RNA, then protein. So this is telling about the processing raw information, telling about the how the protein encoding and what are the function of the particular protein, which is the outcome or which is the product of a particular gene or DNA present. So that would be converted into the databases, and whenever we require, we can find out the particular information. So this is also telling about the phylogenetic relationship. Phylogenetic relation. See, or it predicts the phylogenetic relationship, as well as it is also telling about the regulatory sequences. Regulatory sequences. Now, the phylogenetic relationship means this is the ancestral relationship, how much organism is having the similar genomic structure or chromosome number or the genes. On the other hand, regulatory sequence is that these regulatory sequences are the part of the, suppose this is the DNA strand or the and this is the part or this is the part of regulatory sequence. This is 3 prime, this is 5 prime OH. Now this regulatory sequence is the part of nucleic acid or the part of the DNA which undergo the transcription in either increasing level or in the decreasing level. Because of that, these regulatory sequences are rich with the AU, that is A for adenine and U for uracil. So they are also known as ARE rich region, means adenine, uracil, rich region. So this is the regulatory sequence. If we are talking about the second aspect, second approach of the bioinformatics tool that is used to analysis of a particular gene or to predict the gene. So for that, there are normally programming is done, and that programming is included first one is the gene mark and second one the gene stain. So this is a type of programming. This we call the computer programming or computer program. So this computer program, basically gene mark is giving information about the you information or how we will obtain the information of the particular proteins, which is the outcome of the transcription, translation, or you can say the gene expression. So these protein information is either expressed by the databases, PDB, that is for the protein databases, and that protein databases is telling about the structure of a particular amino acid and sequencing. If we ask on the UniProt KB, so this UniProt KB telling about the annotated protein sequences. So third bioinformatics tools is protein, and it is helpful to sequencing, and it is also able to guess the from which kind of gene a particular protein is evolved. Now next is the regulatory sequence. These regulatory sequence, just I told here about this regulatory sequence. So regulatory sequence is what? It is a segment of nucleic acid that is able to either increase or decrease the gene expression. And these regulatory sequence always present on the 3' OH of the messenger RNA strand, and they are AU rich, and they are also called as the they are also present on the UTR region. You have studied the protein synthesis. So what is the UTR region? UTR region is untranslated region, and this untranslated region does not do the transcription, so they do not make any kind of the particular protein structure. So this is the regulatory sequence. Now next one is the making discovery means we are able, this bioinformatics are exactly making the programs of the databases, and that databases are able to predict finding of new genes that is supposed to be discovered or whose function is still unknown. So this is the making discovery. Now last is inferring phylogenetic relationship. So for this, if you are asking about the poly databases is stand for phylogenetic analysis and alignment of a protein. So this peculiar type of tools is used to predict or guess phylogenetic relationship among closely related species or who have the common ancestry. So these tools is basically describing about the taxonomical tools, or we can say that like a taxonomy browser. So these are the some of the important bioinformatic tools which are used to analysis of a particular kind of information. So nowadays this is the one of the important aspect of the bioinformatics, to know the exact information regarding the protein or gene or its regulatory sequences.